So students, we are here discussing the chapter, the last lesson for our revision, and a few things that we are going to discuss as we read this chapter. One, I have told you earlier, what is the message of this chapter? What do you think is the theme of this chapter? Yes, who's going to tell me? What is it about? Come forward so I can hear you. All of you come forward. Come over here, this side. Yes. What is the theme of this chapter? Last lesson. What does it tell us? Is there anything important that this chapter tells us? What is the message? Yes, it's importance of our language. It is importance of our mother tongue. Right? So if all languages are equal, if all languages are the same, then why do you think the Prussians wanted to impose German language? Why they didn't want the French people to speak French and they wanted to impose their language on them? Why? Why? To spread their own language? Okay, to spread their language. What else? They want more people to speak German. They want to make their language popular. Is it? Yes? Right? They felt their language is superior. Or is it about showing their dominance? That we have conquered your land. We have conquered your country, right? So do you think it was a practice during those times? We talk about here colonization, imperialism, and the rulers there imposing their language. Yes, so it was a way of showing their strength. It was showing that we are in control of things, right? So we are there talking about that all languages are equal. We should give respect to all languages. But this practice over here that we have seen, that how the Germans imposing their language. And this is just one instance that we are talking about. It's happened in many parts across the world. When you look at our country also, we have in the language that we speak influence of the people who have ruled over us. So if we're using a little bit of Urdu words, if we have, you know, a great, when we talk about, remember the bakers of Goa? Yes, the Portuguese influence, we have the French influence. We have the British influence. Of course, it's quite visible right now, the way we're speaking the language. So the people who were there, the rulers, so it was to show that who is in control, to show their authority, to show their dominance. That was one thing that they did. That was impose their language, right? And at least, you know, in a way that M. Himmel, when he tells the people there, when he tells the students and he tells the villagers, he tells them to hold on to their language. That if you have that connection with your language, if you have pride in speaking your language, you'll want it to be a part of your life. You'll struggle hard, you'll work hard, and you will make sure that you get that opportunity to speak your language again. Right? Now, as we read the chapter, there are so many things that we come across. Little incidents that happen. So who were the Prussians? What did Prussia comprise of? Prussia, which areas did it comprise of? What did the Prussians do? Yes. What did they do? They invaded France. These are things you have to learn now. Which districts did they capture? The districts of Alsace and Lorraine. Mohit, wake up and sit properly in the class. Attentively. Please underline this. Please note this down. These are things which you have to remember. As I've told you, it's going to be a multiple choice question, okay? So you have to be very, very particular about the details, okay? Right? And what about the notice board? When did Franz see the notice board? When? Yes, while coming to school. But did he stop there? What did the people think about the notice board? Or what did Franz think about the notice board? What do you think about that? Was it a harbinger of good news or bad news? Good news. Bad. And they got all the news there, right, about the notice for the next day. It was there about the capturing of the districts, about the drafting for the war and all. Right, so all these here, it was there for them, of course. So he thought that the notice board is not exactly a nice place because, yeah, you don't get much nice information from there, okay? Right, so as he moves towards school, what are the things that generally distracted Franz? So I'm giving you options over here. Let me see if you can tell me what are the things that generally distracted Franz. Why did it not like going to school? It was too far away. The school was very far away. He had to walk a lot, right? Was it? Or his bag was very heavy? Yes. Or he did not like his teacher? So please look at these options. Can you see the board over here? So why didn't Franz like coming to school? The school was too far away. His bag was heavy. He did not like his teacher. He liked to play outside. If you read the chapter carefully, you will also find that he did not like the teacher also because of his ruler. Right, the teacher was very strict there with the ruler, right? So now, these are questions where we have two correct options. So you have to be very, very particular about that. So you could easily say, because we know one thing, that is, Franz did not like to go to school. He liked to play outside, right? So what was the reason there? So we have found two reasons. So make sure where you will be getting questions with two correct answers also. So once again, I'm giving you reminder again and again that when we do our multiple choice questions, please be thorough with the text. Okay, can we just decide the sequence which led the teacher leaving the country? Hemal had to leave the country. He decided to leave the country as his services were no longer required. Yes? What were the sequence of events that led M. Hemal to leave the country? Can you put down those sequences? Can you write your sequence? I'll write mine. Write down yours. Come on, write down. What will be the first thing? What will be the first thing? The capturing of? Yes, the capture of which? The district. Yes. Then, imposition of the Germans, of Prussians, or the rule. Then, as a result, what happened? No. Learning of French. Hemal had to leave the So these are the sequence of events that can tell us. Okay, can you see the blackboard? I'll show you. Yeah, you can. I know, Mohit. You can see the blackboard. I'm asking the students at home. Okay, so if you get questions which are there, you know, like what is the correct sequence? Of course, I have written in the correct sequence. You would have to identify the correct sequence. So it could be 1, 2, 3, 4. It could be 4, 1, 2, 3. It could be 3, 2, 1, 4. Four different options would be given to you, and you have to identify the correct sequence. Clear? Yes. So two kinds of questions we have done. One where there can be two correct answers. One is, yeah. Where? Like in the first one. Yes, it can be when two options are there. It can be like only one and two and one, right? Or three, and you have to select which is there. Fine, right? Now here, of course, I have written them in sequence. The events, they could be jumbled also, right? Now let us see here. Of course, your simple direct questions would also be there, but I would like you to just to practice a few more here of sequences. Tomorrow I might do assertion and reason based also. And you're wondering that how in language we can get these assertions and reasons. Okay, I can get a statement here, right? So the statement could be that so I've just picked up here. What could be there? Yes, please. So MML was dressed in his best attire. Why? Because he always wore it on Mondays. He wore it on special days. He was never going to wear it again. Abhishek, give me the answer. Shashank, can you give me the answer? Why was he in his best attire? Ankit, you give me. Why was he in his best attire? Yes? What was he wearing? What was there so special that Franz noticed later that he is wearing something different? See, when I am going to do the revision in these days, don't think that ma'am is going to just stand here and give us a lecture about the summary of the chapter. No. Your involvement is equally important. If you know about the chapter, you'll be able to give the answers. And little details you should know. Right? Yes? So can you give me the correct answer? Yes, at home, students? What is it? He wore it on special days. Yes, thank you, Akriti, for the right answer. And what was so special about that day? It was the last day of Mazer Hemel at school, right? And then he was leaving his country. So it was a special day. Not exactly special in the sense as it was earlier, you know, like inspections or prize distribution days, but it was when he's showing his loyalty, his patriotism, and of course he wants to leave respectfully. Yeah. Read that. See, we have not read the chapter at all. We have not read it. So ma'am is not going to give you the summary at all. Okay. Now, yes, do you think that the Germans were very, very powerful? Now, just see, have a look at the screen again. What are the things here? Now, just look here. Can you see this page here? All of you turn to the second page here. When he says that, what a thunderclap these words were to me. What a thunderclap were these words to me. On page four, find the line. Page four. What a thunderclap these words were to me. What is a thunderclap? What's a thunderclap? How does thunder come? How do you hear this sound of thunder? Loud and deafening. And of course, you get scared also hearing the sound of thunder. So what a thunderclap these words. So how are these words a thunderclap? What were they? They were spoken loudly. Now tell me the correct answers. Let us do a simple one. Yes, when he says, what a thunderclap these words were to me. So, were they spoken loudly? Were they announced loudly? Where is it a deafening sound the way he spoke it? So, it was a shocking news, okay? So, you can be able to identify, okay? Now, all of you look at the next paragraph here. My last French lesson. Why? I hardly knew how to write. I should never learn anymore. I must stop there then. Oh, how sorry I was for not learning my lessons, for seeking birds' eggs, or going sliding on the Saar. My books that had seemed such a nuisance a while ago, so heavy to carry, my grammar and my history of the saints were old friends now that I could not give up. And MML too, the idea that he was going again, that I should never see him again, made me forget all about his ruler and how cranky he was. What are the things here in this paragraph? Are they the things that made Franz realize that he's going to miss so many things? Or was it because of all these things he was not able to complete his lessons or was not up to the mark in his studies? Yes? What were the things he did when he didn't want to study? All these things, seeking birds' eggs and going sliding on the Saar, right? And his books, so he didn't feel like opening them. He didn't like his books. He didn't like the teacher. So these were the things that did not allow him to be what? Up to mark in his studies. I want to see you with your books always. Right? Don't come to class without the book. I don't have to give you. You can open your book. Erase the other book. Wow, great. Then keep it there only, please. Okay? You're isolating the book. Poor man, it was in honor of this last lesson that he had put on his fine Sunday clothes. What do you understand by Sunday clothes? Fine Sunday clothes. So Sunday is a holiday, so we wear nice clothes on Sunday. Then Sunday we wear comfortable clothes. And why is he wearing these fine Sunday clothes? Because people go to church on Sunday. And when they go to church, they wear nice clothes. So fine Sunday clothes. Please write this down. Write it down. So they can ask that, why was he wearing his fine? What do you mean by fine Sunday clothes? When you go out to dinner on a Sunday? That is what you wear when we go to church, right? So, yes, so his fine Sunday clothes. And and now I understood why the old men of the village were sitting there in the back of the room. It was because they were sorry too that they had not gone to school more. It was their way of thanking our master for his 40 years of faithful service and of showing their respect for the country that theirs was theirs no more. So why is their country no longer theirs? It's been taken over by the Prussians, right? They've imposed their orders. And now, as a consequence here, they have realized their mistake. Okay? So why the villagers are not in their best clothes? Because it's not a Sunday? Then? Because they have come to attend the class. And they have come to say thank you in their own way. Right? So that is why, of course, here. Now, while I was thinking of all this, I heard my name called. It was my turn to recite. What would I not have given to be able to say that dreadful rule for the participle also very loud and clear and without one mistake? So, but I got mixed up on the first words and stood there holding onto my desk, my heart beating and not daring to look up. What are the feelings of Franz in this paragraph? What does he feel? Is he feeling regretful? Is he feeling ashamed of himself? Is he feeling embarrassed? Or is it all three? Yes? Is he embarrassed? He wanted to be so good, the teacher is leaving. He wanted to show that, yes, I am learning and I can understand. But what happened? He got his words mixed up, right? Then, of course, he is regretting also. Please read the chapter tomorrow. Bring your book. Read this chapter thoroughly, thoroughly. And be ready with the answers tomorrow. Tomorrow again, I'll just carry on with this, Sonia, otherwise.